Mrs. Duke with you again. How are you holding up?
Yeah. Well, same every day. you know, same as everyone, I guess.
Right.
I mean, just hanging in.
Are you equipped for moments like these?
I mean, am I a doomsday prepper? No.
For times of great strife, can you do that?
I am. I'm a little bit of a stuffer of feelings.
Oh,
so, yeah, I'm good at stuffing anxiety and feelings and,
sure.
You know, carrying on. I've always kind of been like that. But, you know, I've had a few moments the last few weeks that have been hard. But,
right, I can imagine.
Yeah.
It can be tough.
You know, I have a 3- and a 6-year-old, so I mostly
Well, listen, we appreciate you calling in today.
Yeah.
The new record is called Pick Me Up Off the Floor. It's Nora Jones who's on the phone with us now. I'm going to play a song off this record, then we'll come back and talk to you about how it is and how you put this together. Especially nowadays, because after the initial onslaught of the news, music is what people are turning to, right? We'll play a song called I'm Alive. We'll come back. We'll speak some more with Nora Jones. This is The Strombo Show on CBC Music.
Just say the thing you know and play.
you know, it felt very personal to me, even though a lot of the songs are not about personal things in my life, they're about more global society things, but some of them are very personal, and now it feels very, like, we're all going through a very personal time together, and we're all going through the same thing, so, yeah, it just feels more relevant than I thought it would.
Now, is it correct that you did not intend to put it on a record, like the idea with these songs, but they were not supposed to be part of one album?
Yeah, I was trying very actively not to make a record the last 2 years, and I was trying to find ways to stay musical and stay home with my kids, and I ended up doing all these recording sessions with different people and releasing singles, and that was kind of my way to kind of keep going, but as I threw another log on the fire every few months, I just got more and more inspired, and I ended up having a lot of extra material from all these sessions. And I started listening to them. I was walking my dog and realizing that I loved them and that they were an album. They all fit together and they were an album on their own. So I decided to start thinking of it that way.
These sessions and the collaborators that you worked with, which I imagine has got to be pretty liberating as an artist just to be able to do that.
Yeah, I mean, it's been really fun and it's been more inspiring than I could have ever thought because the actual goal and actual plan to go in for 1 to 3 days with somebody, it didn't matter if it was just a musician to play with, or a singer, or a producer, or just an engineer, like, there were no rules, basically. And just to sort of try something new out, and the goal was to release one song from each session, but each session ended up being, you know, 3 to 7 songs, because usually when you get in a room with somebody, it's just exciting, and it's just fun, you know, I got to work with Hank, Mariana, and Hank Paul from Tank of the Bangers, and she's become a good friend. I made friends through this as well, you know? So it's been nice.
Mavis Staples as well.
Yeah, Mavis, and Tank and Mavis I've both known for a while, but to actually, and Jeff Tweedy even I've known for years, but like, I've never gotten to go in the studio with them and just play, like, just the two of us, and write for 3 days, and just having a low commitment also, I think it makes it easier for people to be able to actually commit to collaborating and doing something. So it's been super fun in that way.
Do you ever just sit at the piano and for fun, just learn other people's songs?
I do it when I have a reason to, or if I just hear a song and I love it, I sometimes just sit down and do it. But yeah, it's a really great diving board for like a whole new world of inspiration to do that. I did it a couple weeks ago to the Guns N' Roses song. It was amazing. You know, I had the best time.
Which song?
Patience.
Oh my goodness. I mean, that's an absolute classic.
Yeah, it was great. I mean, I've always loved it, but, you know.
Did you nail the vocals?
I tried to get my act on. I'm not quite as fabulous, but I did my own little version.
But the key to that song is the whistle. Did you get that down?
With the speakers, I can't whistle, so I didn't do the whistle, but that's okay.
That's a tragedy. But why didn't you do it?
I just can't physically whistle, so.
Seriously? Okay, we're going to get into that. That's for another interview, that's when we can dive into that. I don't know what it's like to have kids, but I can assume that it's challenging in this respect. What is your relationship like with quiet these days?
That's a good question. I started meditating last year for the first time, and it's really enhanced my experience with quiet time. It's been life-changing, actually. And it's funny how this isolation and this whole quarantine thing has completely stopped many of us from our busy lives, from what we think is important to what is really important, and, you know, It is hard to keep this, I will say, but it is different to be alone with your thoughts. And I learned this when I was starting to meditate last year as well. It's pretty nice to just kind of slow down and try to sit still. And I realized I hadn't done it in many years.
Was it easier to pick up?
I